there's one from Nong-O on the inside now. Will we see the elbows early? Points a right hand! Smack bang! The uppercut! The uppercut! Too awesome! He's a machine! He's a monster! He's a jackhammer! He's still the champion! He's still the champion!
Nong-O Gaiyanghadao has ruled the one Bantamweight Muay Thai division with an iron fist. Having already defeated three challengers for his crown, to determine the next warrior to step up and challenge Nong-O, the four-man one Bantamweight Muay Thai tournament was held, featuring four of the very best strikers on the planet. In the first semi-final, Samipet Fairtex faced Rodlek PK.Saenchai Muaythaigym. It was a clash of styles as the aggressive Rodlek marched forward on the quick counter-striker Samipet.
Rodlek looking for career victory number 129. He has a 74% winning rate. In Muay Thai, folks, anything above 70% is considered fantastic. When you go above 80%, it's considered phenomenal. And once again, Samipet is at 86%. He's right up there with the likes of Saenchai and Muaythaigym, who also both have 86% finishing rate. We go to the towers at the end of one dragon, a feeling out process there, though I do feel that Samipet got in the better Selva.
Yes, you can see Samipet was able to kind of figure out in the second half of that round the timing of Rodlek, especially when Rodlek goes up top for the head kicks. You can see just that incredible reaction time from Samipet, how he's able to lean back. And you can see from Samipet just that incredible reaction time, how he's able to lean back and answer all those shots coming from Rodlek. Because he has those incredible eyes, you can see how he's able to counter, come back from Rodlek's attacks, especially when Rodlek goes for those big head kicks. I see the advantage of Rodlek. It's going to be coming from the hands and punishing with the low kicks, because Samipet is able to read those shots exceptionally well.
Wherever you're watching, folks, right around the world, in over 150 countries, hope you're enjoying all the action of our main event here at One Championship. No surrender today. How did you start first round? That 10-point must happen. Give the winner of the round 10 points. The less dominant athlete, 9 points. Second round of three. The chance to move through in this tournament. Jab, a high kick there from Samipet. Talked about the power of the rear leg of Rodlek, but Samipet, no slouch with his rear leg. It's a prime weapon throughout his entire career. There it is again, and Rodlek was just able to get the head out of range in time. Tries to back off Samipet with that right hand. Samipet goes downstairs. On the outside here, Samipet circles off counterclockwise. Samipet, very straight up in his stance here. Rodlek, the chin tucked, looking through the brow. High kick, elbow there from Samipet. Now drifts off to his left. Ground kick to the lower right rib cage there from Samipet. Leans back, throws a cutting upward elbow. Clinch now, chance for the knees. Referee gives him a slap and a tickle and breaks them. 2 minutes remaining, second round of three. Intriguing contest. We've really seen Samipet bring the elbows into play in the first and here in the second round. Rodlek, team kick for the lead. There's a team kick from Samipet. Another dashing elbow from Samipet. Evades the hooking punches from the steel locomotive. Rodlek goes downstairs with that team. Two power-packed athletes here. Uppercut, round kick from Samipet. A succulent combination. Rodlek has him against the ropes. And look at the quarter angle turn. Gets back to center ring. Now puts Rodlek on the outside. The footwork from Samipet takes the inside leg kick. Dragon, this one is so close.
Yes, but Samipet just seems to be a step ahead. He just has a clear speed advantage, and he's lightning fast with his movement. You can see how Rodlek is trying to get him up against the ropes, but these beautiful turns and pirouettes coming from Samipet are something special.
The shape of Semipek. You see the online videos on his social media accounts of him training at Fairtex. And he just looks on the money tonight. Ripped, stripped and striated. More muscles than a seafood platter on Semipek Fairtex tonight. And as Mitch said, he's fast, he's accurate, offensively and defensively. And those elbows, again, you saw the crossing elbow, the downward elbow, there in the knees and the clinch. It's all scoring on the judges' card for Semipek Fairtex. 20 seconds to go in the second round. Now Rodlek backs him up with a good leg kick. Rodlek needs to unleash those hooks. The hooks and the leg kicks are what Rodlek is known for. The steel locomotive needs to fuel the engine and get going here. Semipek goes downstairs, two down, one to go. Dragon, we take a look at some of the action here, and I'll go two rounds to nil on my unofficial scorecard to Semipek Fairtex.
Yes, those beautiful counter shots coming from Semipek. He just has a reaction time that is second to none. But Rodlek was able to have some success when he started working the body. He was able to kind of trap Semipek up against the ropes. He was able to start attacking the body. Semipek's got good eyes, so his head movement's there. So Rodlek needs to keep those hands on Semipek, keep that pressure coming, and start attacking those legs to stop that movement.
Semipek Fairtex receiving the instructions from the Fairtex team. I'm pretty sure they're telling him just what you're doing. It is all working for Semipek. Meanwhile, the steel locomotive needs to put the foot down. He needs to go now, and he's going to go hard. Start pounding away with that real leg. Bring the hooks over the top and really pressure the 26-year-old Semipek. Semipek opens up jabbing. What a story he is, Semipek Fairtex. Born and raised in Chiang Mai. Grew up in poverty, where his family's main source of income was collecting plastic bottles. And here he finds himself, one of the highest earning Muay Thai athletes on the planet. On the biggest stage of all, one Super Series. Competing in yet another main event. Rodlek, who had his first match at a temple fair when he was only 10 years old in Koh Samui. The youngster think he would come this far. A multiple world champion. WPMF world champion. Channel 7 Stadium world champion. But at the moment, the world champion is not pulling out all the stops. He needs to, with 2 minutes remaining. Front kick from Semipek. Eyes up Rodlek now. They tango against the ropes. Knee from Rodlek. Trying to gain an advantageous position. Snaking the arms inside. The referee breaks them. Semipek, who's been letting the elbows fly all night. The downward elbows, the uppercut elbows, diagonal elbows. Oh, look at the evasion. Slip to the outside and counters with a two-punch. It's the small details sometimes on Semipek. You've got to love and respect. Crossing elbow there. Outside leg kick from Rodlek. Outside leg kick from Semipek. 1:15 remaining now. They tie up at center ring. Is there an elbow here for Semipek? Maybe off the right arm. He smiles, grins. Rodlek has words with him. 1 minute remaining now. This has certainly been a better round for Rodlek. It may be Rodlek's best round of the contest so far, but will it be enough? Big looping hand there from Rodlek, but Semipek saw it coming. It was telegraphed. Front kick from Semipek. Jumping knee from Semipek. Cracking leg kick from Rodlek. The steel locomotive presses forward now. Time is the enemy of Rodlek. Such a rivalry between these two gyms, Fairtex and PK.Saenchai Muaythaigym. 20 seconds now. Has Rodlek got one big Hail Mary shot? Maybe a leaping hook, maybe a high kick, something, anything to possibly drop Semipek Fairtex. Checks the kick. One big power salvo, maybe, from Rodlek. He fires the hand, fires the kick. Semipet smiles. They get down on their knees. Look at the sportsmanship.
Yeah, it was a much better round for Rodlek in this third final because you could see that constant pressure. He was able to land some big shots, but it was just those little turns constantly coming from Semipet. His reaction time is absolutely beautiful, and he was able to counter very well.
Despite Rodlek's best efforts, Semipet took the victory, securing his spot in the final.
The red corner, Semipet Fairtex!
The second semifinal was between Songmani Klong Swan Plu Resort and Kulabdam Sorjor Piek Uthai. All eyes were on a seven-time Muay Thai world champion Songmani as the tournament favorite, but Kulabdam was ready to prove his critics wrong.
Over the last 3 years has been one of the highest earning Thai stars in the Thai stadiums. Songmani 8-2 in his last 10, 2-0 in one super series. That beautiful, exquisite, Muay Femur style of Songmani. Nice jab there. Southpaw stance on both these athletes. Songmani, who began training in Muay Thai as a six-year-old, also competed for the first time at that age. There was such excitement in the Muay Thai community around the world when last year Songmani signed for the Super Series. Mitch, I am shocked. I am stupefied. I cannot believe that Kulabdam knocked out Songmani with one punch in one round.
With one perfect punch, Kulabdam secured his spot in the tournament final, where he would face an unexpected foe, Rodlek. Despite winning, Semipet suffered an injury that forced him out of the final, and Rodlek got a shot at redemption. This time, Kulabdam came in as the favorite to win the tournament, but Rodlek had no intention of letting his second chance go to waste.
He's a WPMF World Champion, Channel 7 Stadium World Champion, Rodlek. Last year, Kulabdam was the Lumpini Stadium Fighter of the Year. In 2017, he was the Sports Writers of Thailand Fighter of the Year, which is the equal to winning the Ballon d'Or in football, the highest award you can receive in Thailand. Still a filling up process, you feel, for both of these men. Such a lot on the line. A chance to meet the great, untouched champion at Bantamweight, Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. Probing jab from Kulabdam. Again, Rodlek slowly trying to press him to the outside. Counter right hand down the tube there from Rodlek. Range finding lead hand from Kulabdam to set up that left leg. Set up maybe a jab to the two beamer. Power shot, the money shot, the one they call the left meteorite. Rodlek goes high. There's a looping punch off the backhand from Rodlek. End of the first round, we go to the towels. Hope you're enjoying the action, folks, wherever you're watching around the world. A big hello to Prom Suk. Pitchamon Prom Suk in Doncaster, East Melbourne, Australia. Pitchamon Prom Suk, I hope you're enjoying it. One championship from Bangkok. Your thoughts, Dragon?
Interesting first round. You can see the mutual respect from both athletes. That right hand was probably the most significant punch of the round landed by Rodlek. We got to see a feeling out process from both these guys. They normally typically start a little bit faster. Kulabdam usually jumps out the gate firing, but he knows just how good Rodlek is, so he's taking his time and feeling out that process. But I like the way they're both landing the low kicks, just scoring the points and letting things add up.
A couple of more
Muay Thai stars, letting me know they're watching around the world. Big hello to Tiffany Van Soest in San Diego, California, and also to Kevin Ross in Los Angeles, California. Second round, how do you score the first one, folks? Let us know on all your social media platforms. Follow ONE Championship on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. You give the first round 10-9 to Rodlek. You give it 10-9 to Kulabdam. Rodlek comes out kicking. Kulabdam threading that jab off the right hand. There's the jab two. There's the left kick. There's the right teep. You sense that they are upping the aggressive meter. Good hook off the lead hand there from Kulabdam. Outside leg kick, the back leg from Kulabdam. More volume coming already here. The filling out process is over. Probing jab, Kulabdam goes to the bread basket, hits the back leg again. Catch of the kick from Rodlek. Couldn't land a sweep though, couldn't upend him. Body shot from Rodlek, move into a clinch. Chance for the knees, chance for the elbows. Nothing happening, and referee Yomsak breaks them. Rodlek 128 wins in 174 outings. A very solid 74% win rate. 77% winning rate on Kulabdam. That spectacular first round knockout of Sangmani last time out. The combination he floored Sangmani with was nothing short of phenomenal. In boxing, it's a 1-4-5-2. A jab, rear hook, lead uppercut, cross. It was superb. That uppercut went so high, I heard organs playing. Dances with him across the ring. Referee says release the leg. Goes to the body. Jabs again from Kulabdam. Nice left cross there from Kulabdam. Rodlek with the hook off the left hand. Kulabdam a short knee to the lower right ribs. Referee Yongsak keeping the action flowing here. Mitch, your thoughts as we're past the halfway mark of the contest.
Rodlek said earlier this week that he believes that Kulabdam is a one-trick pony and he's only got that left hand. So all he has to do is keep his right hand glued to his head and it's going to eliminate any possible danger that's going to come from Kulabdam. And right now, he's doing a good job of avoiding that left hand and keeping Kulabdam on his back foot.
Overhand right there from Rodlek. Uppercut on the inside. Both men jousted for position. Was that a crossing elbow off the left there from the left meter? Right, there's an uppercut elbow. There's a left hand again from Kulabdam. Hooks from Rodlek. Moves into a grapple. Uppercut left hook. Rodlek! Beautiful shot from Rodlek. The uppercut to the left hook from the steel locomotive. And Kulabdam down. He's up by the count of seven. But Rodlek has dropped him in the final stages of the round. Rodlek comes forward. The steel locomotive. Is it going to be a runaway train now? Well, Kulabdam getting dropped by Rodlek in the second round. How about that? We've got ourselves a war. We're going into the third. Mitch, did you expect it? Did you see it coming? Rodlek dropping the left meter right.
Look at this. Everybody was talking about the power of Kulabdam, but Rodlek says, nope, it's my turn to show you I got power too. Look at this combination. Beautiful uppercut to the hook, and Kulabdam crumbles. That was a beautiful shot from Rodlek. Watch it again. Touches him with the left hand, goes right in for the right hand, separates inside the clinch. Look at him. Has the back of the head, lets it go, hits him with the uppercut, and follows with the left hook. Beautiful combination from Rodlek.
The way that Kulabdam went down, the way he planked on the canvas, belly down, I thought he wasn't going to get up for a moment. Took a few seconds to recompose himself, shake it all back into place and got to his feet, but that will be a 10-8 round for Rodlek. There's a lot of ground now for the left meteorite to cover. The Muay Mat style of Kulabdam is not coming through at the moment. He's got to find the same combinations he used against Sangmani, and Rodlek will be oozing confidence. The steel locomotive who had his first match at a temple fair when he was only 10 years old in Koh Samui. Before the the loss to Semipet, and the semi-finals, he was riding a hat-trick of wins, Rodlek, over Liam Harrison, Andrew Miller, and Chris Shaw. Those three wins have broken a six-match skid for the steel locomotive. Oh, again! Kulabdam goes down! He almost got folded in half, like origami. The second knockdown in this contest. Kulabdam up quicker this time, but here's Hurt. Can Rodlek finish? The steel locomotive comes forward, kicks the legs. Kulabdam is hurt. He's a damaged man. Rodlek's going to look for the finish. Goes the body, goes the liver. It's the body that's hurt. That's where he's taken punishment. Rodlek knows it. Edges forward again. The ferocious steel locomotive. He seems to have Kulabdam's number. Kulabdam not throwing. He's not all there. Rodlek throws a knee. Ties him up. Will he pull the head down for the meet and greet? No. There's a cut on Rodlek, but it doesn't bother him. He's had worse cuts in shaving. Uppercut went higher than my cholesterol. But Kulabdam still can't find the target here on Rodlek. Rodlek at the inside thigh. Kulabdam is worried. His corner is worried. Rodlek getting a second life in this tournament after losing to Semipet, but he thought he won it. There's another hooking punch to a leg kick combination. Rodlek is on song. He is doing everything perfect at the moment, the steel locomotive. Can he take out this four-man tournament? Can he book a date with the champion Nong-O Gaiyanghadao? Kulabdam's got to find a way to shake off the cobwebs to get back in this match. Rodlek comes forward. Extension on the left hand. Resets. Orthodox stance on Rodlek. Southpaw on Kulabdam. Rodlek getting his lead foot on the outside of Kulabdam's lead foot. Steps around nicely. Look at that little quarter angle turn there from Rodlek. We are getting into the final seconds of the final round. It's going to be Rodlek's match. Unless Kulabdam can knock him out, it'll need a miracle from the left meteorite. But I don't think there's a miracle in Bangkok for Kulabdam tonight.
Rodlek stormed through Kulabdam, winning the tournament and earning a shot at one Bantamweight Muay Thai World Champion, Nong-O Gaiyanghadao.